I'm Veronica Wasek, and I help Shopify sellers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems. So you may be a Shopify seller or Shopify bookkeeper working on QuickBooks Online, and you have Shopify income and PayPal, and all of a sudden you see that you either have double or tripled income in your QuickBooks Online. So why is QuickBooks doing that? Actually, QuickBooks Online is not the one doing it. It's you. I hate to break this to you. QuickBooks Online is not doing it. It's actually you, and it's likely because you have an incorrect workflow. In this video, I'm going to show you the incorrect workflow that's causing you to have overstated income in QuickBooks, and I'm going to show you the correct workflow so that you can make this problem go away once and for all. Let's take a look at the types of transactions that normally are recorded from Shopify and PayPal. From Shopify, we have transactions such as income, refunds, returns, sales taxes collected, gift cards, tips, and payments processed via PayPal and other payment gateways. From PayPal, we will see deposits received for sales made in Shopify, fees deducted, transfer to the bank account, and other types of transactions such as funds held, funds released, expenses, and other. But if you don't understand the proper way of recording Shopify income and PayPal transactions, typically what we see is that untrained users are recording income three times in QuickBooks. So how does that happen? First of all, Shopify sales are recorded into QuickBooks using A2X or another app. And then in the PayPal bank feed in QuickBooks, amounts received from PayPal are recorded as PayPal income. So notice now we've recorded income two times. And then a third time, in the bank account feed in QuickBooks, amounts transferred from PayPal to the bank account are recorded as income once again. So that's income being recorded three times. In order to avoid duplicating or triplicating, if that's a word, PayPal income, then we need to follow the correct Shopify PayPal workflow. So here's the correct workflow. You're going to record Shopify income using A2X, which is my preferred app for recording Shopify income into QuickBooks. That will record income just the one time. From the PayPal bank feed, you will record amounts received from PayPal to the Shopify PayPal clearing account. I did a separate video explaining clearing accounts. I will link that for you in the description. Next, in the PayPal bank feed, you will record transfers from PayPal to the bank account. And then in the bank account feed, you will match transfers from PayPal into the bank account feed. Let's go through how this works. First of all, I am using the accountant's view in this tutorial. You can switch to the accountant's view in QuickBooks from the gear icon. So go to the upper right-hand corner, look for the gear icon, click on that icon, and then click to switch to the accountant's view. From the banking transactions in QuickBooks, you will start with the PayPal bank account. You will see all of the transactions flowing into PayPal, and you will see that those are being deposited into the PayPal bank account. Here's an example of one transaction. Just click on that transaction. It will expand the window and show you this additional information. Next, under transaction type, select deposit. And for the account category, select Shopify PayPal clearing. What you should see then is a transaction type of deposit and the category Shopify PayPal clearing. And from the bottom right, click add. By following this step, then you avoid duplicating income because we already recorded the income using A2X. Next, to record any transfers from PayPal to the bank account, you will likely see a transaction that says withdrawal to bank account. Click on that transaction to expand the window, and you will choose the option to record a transfer. Under Select Transfer Account, select your bank account. And from the bottom right, select Record Transfer. Now you will go to the bank account feed in the banking transactions, and you will see the transfer from PayPal. You'll notice that QuickBooks will tell you that it found a matching transaction. So all you have to do is to match the transaction in QuickBooks. And again, by doing this, we are avoiding entering income more than one time in QuickBooks. All right, so I just showed you the incorrect workflow that's leading to you having overstated income in QuickBooks and the right steps to follow so that you can avoid this problem. I hope that this video was helpful to you, and let me know in the comments if you've come across this issue in your own books. I'm Veronica Wasek. If this content is helping you, then subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. If you're looking for a trusted and reliable Shopify accounting pro, check the description below to learn more about my services and to see if we'd be a good fit for working together. Also, check the description below to learn all about my free resources, including my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint, the link to join my Facebook community, and to learn more about my Shopify bookkeeping course. I'll see you next time.